this is just fantastic. Absolutely love it. Absolutely.
So I honestly didn't expect to make a new video from Denmark this soon, just after the other one. But we had a lot of snow this night. So what I've learned from doing tours in Iceland is just to jump on the opportunities when they're there. So that's what I'm doing. And I also did that the other morning. So I want to show a little clip from the other morning where me and Sophie were out photographing in some very foggy conditions. So over the past month and actually years, I have pinned down different locations of interest in my local area. And one of them is down here next to the largest stream we have in Denmark. It's called Gudenåen. And as you can see here in the background, we have these dead trees and I find them quite interesting. So basically just been waiting for the right conditions to go out and photograph them in. So last night we got a lot of snow and now it has all started thawing. So there's actually some really nice atmosphere and a lot of fog in the air, and that's exactly what I waited for. So we get this separation between the trees and the background. Well, and as you can see, there is actually no background whatsoever. But if there were no fog, there would be some forest back there in the background. So we get these very isolated and moody trees, which is just like lined up perfectly. So because of these next to nearly perfect conditions, what I'm doing from a photography technical standpoint is super easy. So I basically just find my exposure and I put in like f11, f13 here on the long lens. There is a little bit of depth because I do have some foreground, so I will have to focus stack it. So I'm basically just like zooming all the way in, making sure that the trees are in focus. And then I just adjust the focus. Well, I take the shot, then I adjust the focus for the foreground, take a new shot, and then for the nearest foreground, take a third shot. And then I just combine those in Photoshop. There's so many ways you can do it manually or through some scripts or whatever in Photoshop. Very easy. I kind of feel that it's so easy that it's almost cheating. Like you pin down a point of interest, then you wait for the weather to behave in a certain way, then you just go out, take the shot, go home. You hardly need to adjust it because it's fog. So yeah, that was it. It's almost too easy. So about this location, like the road is literally just up here behind me and there's a house, and you can see like it's not the most sexy place, especially not when we have like just only a little snow. If there was a lot of snow, it would be super, super cool. Like getting out here in a snowstorm would be so cool, because as you can see here, there's this super interesting tree here right behind me. It will have to wait for another time because the foreground here is not like it's not really optimal at all. So it's basically just a waiting game when it comes to this kind of like classic landscape photography. I might not get the shot this year, maybe not next year, maybe in 2 years, I don't know. But until then, there's a lot of other locations that I can go to and I can explore, and I can just like, yeah, wait for the conditions to be right. So I hope you saw that little bird in the background there. It's
quite nice. So today's plan is to go to Rubia Knud Lighthouse, which is a super cool location. I have made one video from there before. It is this lighthouse which is covered by a huge dune. And then you just, of course, like have the single lighthouse pointing out of the dune. And what I expect is that obviously all the snow should cover at least like most of the dune. So it should look somewhat like the lighthouse just standing out of a hill of snow. I think that ought to look pretty cool. It should make for some nice minimalistic photos, especially with just like a blank sky above. So that's at least what I expect from today's tour. There are a couple of other locations which I also want to check out. I think might look really, really cool. A couple of old mills. I don't know if I actually have time to check out both, but I will see to that. It depends on how slow I will have to drive to get up there, because it is a fair bit slippery today. So I will just keep my eyes on the road for now. After all, safety first.
So this mill is called Vindblæse Mill, and the town is called Vindblæse. And Vindblæse literally translates to wind blow. And you completely understand why when you're out here, because there is quite a lot of wind. I've had my eyes on it for quite a while, and I wanted to get up here in the northern part of Jutland and get a shot of it. Like, I would say these old mills makes for quite a nice subject. And we have a homepage, it is in Danish, where we have a map of all the different kind of old mills and water mills we have in Denmark. So they're quite easy to just find the name of them and then just Google them, because there's always some tourist photos of them all over the net. And it's always interesting when you see those photos on Google if it's actually possible to get something from here. But I would say, like, in today's winter wonderland landscape, that it is possible to isolate it quite a lot. Now, my biggest concern is that we haven't had as much snow as I hoped for, at least up here. So there's still a lot of like grass pointing out of the snow. So what I think I will do is to just find a place where there's at least some kind of interesting grass I can use as foreground, which is just like leading up to the mill or something like that. But let's see what I can find. So I'm facing this problem right now that even though my tripod is quite low to the ground, it's not completely like all the way down there. Luckily, it is so bright right now that I can easily handhold and get close to my my foreground. But the problem I'm facing is my focus, because even though it is quite bright and I can shoot at like f/18, I'm still so close to my foreground that the background will be out of focus, and vice versa. So I will have to focus stack this one. So I will take one shot for the foreground and then we'll take one shot for the background and put them together in Photoshop. So I just want to briefly mention that, yeah, I called the mill back there the focal point, and it is just what I try to emphasize in most of my videos when I talk about these. And this is also the main problem why I haven't really been that inspired by Denmark. I've had such a hard time finding a subject, something worth actually photographing. Now, if you can see, like, this photo here, I took that the other morning when I was photographing the lake I live just next by. And as you can see,
there's a lot of interesting things in this image, like the colors are nice, it's cold, we have a foreground, we have some leading elements that leads into the photo, we even have a little sun star, and obviously the sun star is the focal point of the photo, but all in all, it's not like, it's not an interesting focal point, it's just a sunrise, and like we even have like a perfect cloud just above the sun. But yeah, the photo is just like, you know, meh. It's beautiful, it's a scenic place, but it's not photogenic. So I bet when I'm showing you this minimalistic photo of the mill instead, it's just so much stronger as a photo, because there's no doubt about what I'm taking a photo of, even though the photo from that frozen lake is a little bit more complex, it has more colors, maybe even a bit more atmosphere and mood, I don't know. The photo of the mill, I think, will be the stronger photo.
So Rubia Knude, and okay, you can already see my excitement, because this is just, this is perfect conditions, because I was a little bit worried that it might clear because the weather forecast said it would, but right now just have quite a lot of snow. I could see in the distance that there's not that much snow on the dune, but I think I can work around that. There might be some snow patches up there. But the absolutely incredible thing is that I have these very dark and heavy clouds out over the ocean. So I can make a really strong, bright foreground and then have these dark clouds in the background. And it ought to make more or less the same effect as when you have a dark background and you have the foreground lit by the sun. So you drag all the attention to the foreground and the subject you're photographing. And obviously I'm going for some minimalist stuff here. So the first place I found here is actually a place where I have to go really down low to the ground. There's like these beautiful sand shapes of different colors in the dune, and I'm using those as a foreground to like lead the eye into and up to the lighthouse. I'm so close to the ground in the foreground that I have to focus stack this one, and I'm taking like 5 or 6 photos to cover the entire plane of focus. So yeah, there's going to be a little bit of stitching, but I think it's definitely doable. So as you might have guessed, this is just incredibly hard conditions to photograph in, and well, one thing is to photograph, another thing is to also try and vlog it. Right now my biggest challenge is obviously the wind, because
it hits the camera. And even though I used my 24 to 105, it turned out that because I could put my my 70 to 200 on and use this one, it was a bit more stable. I have decided to go for the lens cap, put it on, simply just to keep the front elements more or less clean, because it's just like it's getting so much snow into it. So right now I managed to find some settings which are like ISO 100 and 1/60th of a second, and then f3.6, and I'm just hammering off on continuous shooting just as fast as I can, and then I just cross my fingers that one of the shots are in focus. I do check them from time to time, and it seems I do get some which are in focus. But yeah, it's just incredibly, incredibly hard to photograph. But oh boy, the conditions are just exactly as I wanted them to be. So it's everything one could hope for up here, like super dramatic and minimalistic photos at once. So it simply just does not get any better than this. So I gotta admit that these are some of the more extreme conditions I've photographed in Denmark, but I just absolutely love it. Like, as you obviously can see, the compositions here, they are super strong, they are super minimalistic, super dramatic. Like, I hope you can really feel just the winds and the coldness and yeah, the vastness you can also get from a photo like this. Super powerful, and it's just what I love so much about photography and landscape photography. And this is just fantastic. Absolutely love it. Absolutely. So yeah, as you can see, I'm just getting like the full force of the North Sea towards me right now. Here in the background we have the ocean, and more or less in that direction is Norway. So yeah, it's just getting the full force and a lot of snow in. What I've found is that there's like this small hill on the dune. And when the wind blows in, it blows all the snow over the top, which creates some kind of like a vortex that whirls it around. So I'm trying to catch the moment when one of these vortexes like engulfs the lighthouse. So I kind of have the bottom of the lighthouse washed out, and just have the lighthouse like coming out of this storm of snow. So that's what I'm basically working on right now. So it does take a little patience, but I have more than enough patience right here, because the conditions are amazing, and I'm not super cold. It is not super cold, it's windy and it's snowy, but it's not like minus 10, it's only about like 0 degrees Celsius. So it's quite okay, it's quite okay. So I'm walking around and playing a little bit around, changing the composition just a little. But generally right now I am going for this very dramatic, minimalistic photo. So I've now come to the other side of the lighthouse, and I'm trying to incorporate a foreground here with some grass in the foreground. And well, while walking up this part of the dune, I slipped and smashed my entire camera and the long lens into this frozen dune and completely destroyed my lens set. And it's so annoying when you're not following your own advice. I always say to people that when they walk from one place to another, always pack your camera, because you never know when you slip or something like that and you hit your camera on something. And especially on a day like this, where it's so obvious that there's a big risk of slipping. And of course I slip and I destroy my lens hood. So like, you just feel so stupid when something like that happens. But I'm okay, but it's just so annoying. But right now I'm like just trying to incorporate this foreground, and I think it's quite a cool shot. Like it does give some depth. Right now I'm just waiting for some darker clouds to come in to make a little bit more like dark background, and I think that's the shot. So I won't stay here too long. So Rubia Knude Lighthouse is by far, in my opinion, one of the most epic locations we have in all of Denmark. Like, it's just so unique to have a lighthouse which is getting swallowed by a dune. I have to admit, I have been struggling a bit with trying to find a proper foreground in these conditions. The problem is that there's so much sand and snow which is just like mixed into like a lot of chaos, and I can't really find something which would work as a proper foreground. So instead of that, I'm just going for the long lens and making silhouette pictures like this, and I would say that that's also pretty good. So I hope you enjoyed this video. It was super chaotic and super hard to make, and I'm getting like sand and snow in my eyes. But as always, I hope you enjoyed it, and I would highly appreciate both a like and a comment.